Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Senappa. So in this video we are going to do some PID function block configuration. Okay, so the scenario, we have one pressure sensor input, okay, 0 to 10 volt, and we will with this pressure sensor we are going to control a VFD speed by PID modulation. Okay, so we will do how we can do the configuration. Okay, first we will do the configuration. So now we have selected the M172 PLC with 18 IOs. Okay, first we will configure the analog inputs. So pressure input, okay, and analog output VFD control. VFD okay, then we will do the scaling. So the input we have already considered 0 to 10 volt, okay, and our analog input and the scale, analog input scale is 0 minimum and maximum 100, okay, and our analog output is voltage mode. Okay, then we'll give put set point. Okay, so in status variable set point could be signed as 16D or unsigned 16-bit. Okay, type integer, read only, no, so we are going to change it. Okay, default we'll put some 20 bar. Okay, minimum 0, maximum 100, scale 1. Okay, offset nothing, we'll put unit bar. Okay, now we are going to do the programming configuration. Okay, now we will add program, new program, function block diagram name, we'll put PID control, assign to timed. Okay, now we are in the page. Now we will add function block PID advanced. Okay, we put some name, speed VFD. Okay, now he brought the function block. Okay, function block, it has some inputs as well as outputs. Okay, it has some enable input, present value, set point, manual mode, and low limit, high limit. Okay, auto tune input, auto tune value, and proportional, integral, derivative values. Okay, so sum of inputs need to connect. Okay, or else sum of input, it has some default value. Okay, so that we can see here. So we need to connect main inputs, enable and present value, set point value. Okay, so automatically it has some default value. If you want to adjust those values, we need to add externally. Okay, also it has two analog input. Okay, real value and integer value. Okay, so we will connect anything. Okay, we will connect integer. Okay, now we will connect one constant value for enabling the function block. Okay, okay, so this function will be always enabled. Then present value, present value our analog input. Okay, pressure input, and our set point. Okay, our set point status variable. Okay, here we go. So these values are integer value, so this, it should be real, so we can use converter, integer to real converter. So here we go, conversion to real two block values. Okay. Now we are done, and we will connect output. Okay. This is VD control output analog value. We'll connect in integer value. Okay, now we will check. Okay, we'll do built all. So now we'll test with the like simulation. Okay, we'll go to simulation mode. We'll put some test. Okay. Compile the program. Okay, now live debug mode. Okay, here we go. Now our input is 0, set point is default 20, our analog output is 800. Okay, so it has it's give some value. Okay, because our input is 0, so we will increase our input like 16. Our value, output value decreased. Okay, yes, you can see here 200 it is. Okay, so we'll increase our input 18 more input, so again it's came up. If you give 21, okay, so it's 0. That means based on that set point, it will sense the input. Okay, so and then it will modulate the output. Okay, if it is input is reduced to 5 bar, then it is giving some output. Okay, so VFD will run based on this input. Okay, so this analog output will be given to VFD input as analog input. Okay, so VFD will run and it will try to pump the water and try to match with the pressure with the set point. Okay, if you want to change the set point, we can change 30. Okay, so see our input is 5, our set point is 30, it has given full input. Okay, so now it is 25 over reached, so input has come down, it is goes more than 30, 0. Okay, so this is PID function. Okay, PID function with this, you can, by using this you can control your, or you can modulate your water pump. Okay, through VFDs. So I hope this is useful for you. Okay, if you are first time for my channel, please do subscribe, and I have posted many other videos related to Siemens PLC also. Okay, if you are interested, please watch and support. Okay, we will meet you in next video. Till then, bye from Sinappa.